So this is Dr. T.V. Rao, Professor and Principal, DVS Institute of Technology, Kavali. So today we are going to discuss one-dimensional steady state heat transfer. So one-dimensional steady state conductive heat transfer. So already last class we have discussed. So what is the differential equation for studies heat conduction? Again, so that is for three-dimensional heat conduction, what is the differential equation? That is dou by dou x of k dt by dx plus dou by dou x of k dt by dy plus dou by dou z of k dt by dz plus so q dot, that is heat generation component, equal to this so dou t by dou t into so 1 by alpha. So there will be some three-dimensional equation, that is okay. So now we are going to discuss one-dimensional steady state heat conduction. So one-dimensional steady state heat conduction means, so we are assuming that heat is transferred only in one dimension, in other directions there is no heat transfer. That means that in other direction there is no temperature difference, that is dou t by dou equal to 0, dou t by dou z equal to 0, that is qy equal to 0, qz equal. There is only heat transfer in x direction or one direction, then we can say that it is one dimensional. That too, so we are assuming that it is a steady state heat conduction. And whether it is a steady state heat conduction, so there is no temperature gradient with respect to time. So when time changes, there is no change in the temperature. That is dou t equal to 0. Dou t by dou t equal to 0. We will see. In one dimensional steady state, so we simplified to understand the heat transfer. To simplify the, so heat transfer is a very complex problem. To simplify the heat transfer problems, so we simplified it as we are assuming that heat is transferred in only one dimensional, that to steady state. Then we can understand the heat transfer and we can formulate the equations very easily. In one dimensional heat transfer, heat is transferred in only one direction, that is in x direction. Okay, now in other directions there is no heat transfer, there is no temperature gradients. So here is telling that temperature gradient exists along a single coordinate direction, only in one direction. So wherever there is a temperature gradient, in particular place only there is a heat transfer. Heat is transferred when there is temperature gradient. When there is a temperature difference, there is a heat transfer. And since it is a steady state, it is independent of time. Whether it is a steady state means with respect to time, there is a, so without it's independent of time. That means even time changes, there is no change of heat transfer. That's why you can call it a steady state. So here these are the two main assumptions. One is one dimensional, another one is steady state. Then we can simplify the problem. Okay. So temperature distribution, heat transfer rates. So we are going to discuss in a planar, that means in a plane wall, how is the temperature, how is the heat transfer, how will be the temperature distribution. Similarly in this cylinder, in this sphere, how is the temperature distribution and what will be the heat transfer, how to calculate heat transfer rate. Here temperature distribution means, using this temperature distribution means there is a temperature distribution equation. With the help of this equation, at any point of time we can find out what is the temperature at particular point. That is called temperature distribution equation. Okay, and here So we are introducing a new term called thermal resistance. So thermal resistance. Thermal resistance means so every body should have some resistance. Resistance generally we use in electrical terminology. Electrical terminology means it stops the flow of current. Here also thermal resistance means it stops the flow of heat transfer. That is called thermal resistance. Okay. So with the help of this thermal resistance concept, we simplify the heat transfer equations in a better way. We'll see. So the first we are taking a Cartesian coordinates, we are taking a plane wall. So that means we are going to derive an equation for heat transfer in a plane wall and a temperature distribution equation in a plane wall. So here for a plane wall we are going to study. For plane wall we are going to explain how is the heat transfer in a plane wall, what will be the heat transfer equation, what is the temperature distribution equation. These two are very very important. So we should find out what is the heat transfer equation, what will be the temperature distribution equation. Since it is a one dimensional, this is dou by dou x of integral k into dou t by dou x equal to 0, because dou t by dou y equal to 0, dou t by dou z equal to 0. This is only one dimensional, so this will be the differential equation for one dimensional heat transfer. So this will be the differential equation for one dimensional heat transfer. So in one dimensional heat conduction in a plane wall, so there is no heat generation. So heat flux is a constant and independent of x. Heat flux is a constant. The heat transfer rate is a constant, and it is a steady state. So if you observe, see, so this is a plane wall. So one side there is a hot fluid, other side there will be cold fluid. Okay, so left side, since it is a hot fluid, the temperature is T1 infinity. Hot fluid temperature is T1 infinity. So if hot fluid is touching this plane wall surface, so when it reaches the plane wall, the surface temperature is TS1. TS1 means it is a surface temperature on hot side. When coming to the cold side, when there is a heat transfer, the temperature due to heat transfer, so here the temperature is T2. Here the temperature is T2. Okay. So cold fluid temperature is T2, T2 infinity. Infinity means atmospheric temperature. T2 infinity means cold side. That is the cold fluid temperature. Okay, so there is a heat transfer. So here temperature is T1 and here temperature is T2. T2 is less than T1. Why? Because there will be some thermal resistance. There will be a flow of some resistance against flow of heat transfer. Okay, but the rate of heat transfer is equal. Here the rate of heat transfer is equal. Here the rate of heat transfer is equal. Here the rate of heat transfer is equal. That we will see. The same thing. So this heat transfer we are mentioning in some electrical diagram, electrical circuit diagram. So here the hot fluid temperature is T1 infinity. Okay, and cold fluid hot side surface temperature is TS1. This is TS2 and T2 infinity cold side. So here what is the what type of heat transfer will be there from hot fluid to this surface? There will be heat is transferred in the hot fluid in the form of a convection. In plane wall, the heat is transferred in the form of a conduction. In cold side, the heat is transferred in the form of a again convection. Okay, so between T1 infinity and TS1, so there will be a due to convection heat transfer, there will be some resistance against heat transfer. So this will be the resistance against heat transfer. This is called thermal resistance in convection. Again, when heat is transferred in a plane wall, again there will be some resistance against heat transfer, that is called conductive resistance. Again, cold side, again there is some resistance against, that is also convective resistance. The resistance we have shown just like the resistance symbol. Okay, we will see how to calculate these resistances, that we will see. So this differential equation, this differential equation, to derive this heat transfer equation, to derive the temperature distribution equation, if you integrate this differential equation, so it is a second order differential equation, you have to integrate twice. Whenever we are integrating, we will get constants. If you integrate twice, so we will get the equation like T equal to C1x plus C2. So T equal to C1x, T of x equal to C1x plus C2. Once you integrate the differential equation twice, we will get this equation where C1 and C2 are constants. So here we have to identify, we have to find out what is the value of C1 and C2. To find out C1 and C2, we have to apply boundary conditions. Here, what is the boundary conditions? When x equal to 0, what will be the temperature? When x equal to L, what is the temperature? When x equal to 0, the temperature is TS1. When x equal to L, the temperature is TS2. These are, okay, like this. If you apply the boundary conditions, when x equal to 0, Tx equal to TS1, when x equal to L, TL equal to TS2, these are the boundary conditions. These boundary conditions, if you apply in the temperature distribution equation, we will get two equations. Those two equations will simplify, we will get what is C1 and C2. This C1 and C2, again, if you substitute in this diagram, we will get there is an equation Tx equal to TS2 minus TS1 into x by L plus TS1. This equation is called temperature distribution equation. The equation Tx equal to TX2 minus TX1 into x by L plus TS1. This is the temperature distribution equation in a plane wall. So what is the use of this temperature distribution equation means? Using this equation, at any point across the plane wall, we can find out temperature. Because practically, we cannot find out the temperature across the plane wall. But using this equation, we can find out the temperature across the plane wall. So you should understand what is temperature distribution equation. So what is the use of this temperature distribution equation means, using this equation across the plane wall, at any point when x equal to 0 or when x equal to something, we can find out what is the temperature at particular point with the help of this temperature distribution equation. Now similarly, you have to find out what is the heat transfer. Heat transfer, for conductive heat transfer, the equation is minus Ka into dou T by dou X. So this dou T by dou X means already we know T. So if you differentiate this equation, if you substitute T instead of here in the dT by dX, so we'll get, so dT by dX means this constant becomes zero. So TS2 minus TX1, okay? So d by dx of TS2 minus TX1 into x by L equal to x becomes cancelled. So this becomes Ka into TS2 minus TS1. So Qx equal to Ka by L into TS2 minus TS1. Okay, or this is the heat transfer. See, heat flux means heat transfer per unit area. Heat transfer per unit area equal to K by L into TS2 minus TS1. So like this, we can find out the heat transfer in a plane wall. Okay, so these two equations are very, very important. These two equations, temperature distribution equation and heat transfer equation. Now we'll see how to find out thermal resistance. So thermal resistance means it is a resistance against heat transfer. Thermal resistance means it is a resistance against heat transfer. Okay, here. So how to find out resistance means, so it is a ratio of driving potential to the, corresponding heat transfer. Okay, that means driving potential means temperature difference. Driving potential means temperature difference by Qx. So for conductive heat transfer, TS1 minus TS2 by QX. So if you substitute, okay, QX means we know that KA by L into TS1 minus TS2. TS1 minus TS2 get cancelled. Finally, we'll get L by KA. L by KA is thermal resistance for conduction. So L by KA means thermal resistance for conduction. Similarly, for convection also, if you find out, we'll get 1 by HA. For convection, thermal resistance is 1 by HA. For conduction, thermal resistance will be L by KA. Okay. So radiation that here we won't concentrate that much. That we'll discuss later. For conductive thermal resistance is L by KA. For convective thermal resistance is 1 by HA. Okay. So like this. Now, so there will be conductive resistance. See, here there is a some resistance, here there is a some resistance, here there is a some resistance. Now you have to find out what will be the total resistance. Total resistance means we'll see how to find out the total resistance. Okay, so under steady state condition, there is a one, the rate of heat transfer through convection equal to rate of heat transfer through conduction through wall equal to the rate of heat transfer convection on cold side. Okay, the rate of heat transfers are equal everywhere. Okay, so the rate of the hot side convection heat transfer rate equal to conduction rate across the wall equal to convection rate across the in cold side. Okay, so what is the heat transfer? So that QX, so here there is a QX, here there is a QX. So the heat transfer, the heat transfer rate is same. Here there is a QX, here there is a QX, here there is a QX. There is no change of QX. That's why. So QX equal to on hot side, 2 infinity 1 minus TS1 by 1 by HA equal to TS across the wall, TS1 minus TS2 by L by KA equal to TS2 minus TS T infinity 2 by 1 by H2A. Here H1 and H2 are heat transfer coefficient, K is thermal conductivity. So heat transfer equation, we can write it as the total heat transfer equation across the entire system, T infinity 1 minus T infinity by total resistance. T infinity 1, how we can write? T infinity 1 means T infinity 1 minus TS1 plus TS1 minus TS2 plus TS2 minus T infinity. Okay, like this also we can write. If you write like this, okay, so the total resistance will get 1 by H1A plus L by KA plus 1 by H2A. So this is the total resistance in a plane wall. Okay, so total resistance equal to is nothing but, total resistance is nothing but sum of these three resistances. Total resistance is nothing but the sum of these three. This is convective resistance plus conductive resistance plus convective resistance on cold side. So if it is R1, this is R2, this is R3. R total equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Like this, you can find out the thermal resistance and the total resistance. Okay. So this is radiation that we'll discuss later. Okay, so today we have discussed one-dimensional heat transfer in a plane wall, a single wall. Regarding a composite wall, how is the heat transfer, that we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, so today I will stop. So thank you.